The Wave's SSL E-Channel Strip and G-Channel Strip are some of the most popular plugins for mixing, and for good reason. They sound great, and they can also be used as an all-in-one effects processing unit. One thing that might be overlooked when first using the plugins is the internal routing options. These options allow you to change the order of the various sections of the plugin. There are three sections. One section is the filters section, which consists of a high pass and low pass filter. Another section is the four band equalizer. And the last section is the dynamic section, which consists of a compressor and expander gate. The internal routing options can be used to change the order of these sections, such as put your equalizer before your dynamic section, or put your dynamic section before your equalizer. You can also use the internal routing options to do more advanced techniques, such as de-essing. Why don't we get to an example and I can show you all the different options. Here I have a multi-track drum recording, which consists of several different microphones on the drum kit. I have kick drum over here, snare drum, my toms, overhead, and a couple room mics. Let me go ahead and play it back so you have an idea about how it sounds. On some of the tracks, I've inserted the E-channel strip, and other ones I've inserted the G-channel strip, because the routing is a little bit different on each of these plugins. First, I'll start out with my kick drum track, bring up the E-channel strip. I've got it in its default settings, and the default routing is to first start out with the dynamic section, then go into my filter section, and finally the EQ section. What I'm doing here is just a little bit of compression, and then the expander gate. Then I'm going to enter the filter section, which has a high pass starting around 40 hertz, and then a low pass around 10K. Then I have the four-band equalizer boosting a little bit around 2K and up around 5K to give it some snap and punch. I'm rolling off around 200 and 300 hertz to take away the boxiness, and then boosting finally around 60 hertz just so I can kind of fill out the bottom end of my kick drum. So let's hear how that sounds. On the external microphone, I'm still using the E-channel, but I've clicked on the split button right here. What this is going to do is move the filter section in front of the dynamics. This can be done if you don't want your really low end signal triggering the compressor. This is a popular way to use the plugin, especially for things like kick drum or bass, where in the first situation, the compressor was sensitive to the really low frequencies. But by putting the filter in front, now the compressor and gate are no longer listening to those really low frequencies that you're going to roll off anyway. So let's listen to this. And just to demonstrate that the compressor is not listening to it, if I roll it off, it's no longer listening. I'm doing a similar thing on the sub kick where I had the split engaged, and that's just putting the filters before the dynamic section. Next, let's get to the G channel that I've got inserted on the snare drum. Again, I've got the split button engaged. This, even though it's the G channel strip, is going to do a similar sort of thing. I've got the filters going before the dynamics and then going into the equalizer. On my snare bottom mic, I've decided to use this channel out button. What this channel out button is going to do is put the equalizer in front of the dynamic section. I've also got the split engage, which also puts the filters in front of the dynamic section. So let's listen to this one. just to demonstrate it, if I roll everything out, you'll see that the compressor is not doing as much here, meaning that the equalizer, the signal I'm taking out, is in front, in fact, of the compressor. Now you see the compressor doing more work. I'm doing a similar sort of thing with the E-channel. I've got the channel output engaged so that the equalizer section is before the dynamic section. Same sort of thing. Next, let's go over here to my overhead and room mics and see what's going on with them. I'll start out with this pair of room mics. I've got the G-channel strip going. And what I'm doing is I've got the filter dynamic sidechain engaged. For the overheads and room mics, I'm going to be doing some sidechaining. What I've got when you engage this one is you put the filter section in the sidechain of the compressor. The filters then are no longer affecting the actual signal that's going to pass through, but it's affecting a signal that's separated out and that goes into the dynamic section. What I want for these room mics is my compressor to be heavily compressing this signal. However, I don't want it to be activated by the kick drum. So what I've done is increase the filter to 350 hertz. So that's going to block out all the low end so my compressor isn't listening to the low end. However, I still want those signals, those frequencies in my signal to be present in the actual output. And that's what you can do by moving the filters into the sidechain of your compressor. So let's take a look at this. So you can hear if I disengage the button, now the compressor is responding to the kick drum and the actual output signal has been rolled off below 350 hertz. But I engage this and the compressor isn't doing anything for the kick drum, it's mostly just listening to the snare. You have to make sure not to engage the split button because the split button will put it back before the dynamic section. With this room mic, again, I'm just using the split button so that I put the filters below the dynamic section. Nothing too advanced there. Finally, with my overheads, let's bring this up. On the E-channel strip, the sidechaining works a little bit different. No matter what, when you click on this button, you're going to put the equalizer in the sidechain of the compressor. You can engage the split button, and the split button will put the filters before the dynamic section and out of the path of the sidechain. So in this case, the filters are affecting the actual audio that's passing through the entire plugin. By taking it out, now the filters and the equalizer are both in the sidechain path. And so basically, the input signal, what you're hearing is only the input signal being compressed. You're not hearing any of the equalizer affecting it. So let's look at what I'm doing with the equalizer. What I want to do is use it as a way of getting rid of the harsh components of the cymbals in my overheads. So when there's a loud harsh signal, I want the compressor to kick in. This is what you would typically use a de-esser for on vocals. And because I don't have any vocals here, I wanted to show you how to use it. This would be a similar routing that you would want. So if we actually disengage this, you'll hear what the signal, the equalizer section is doing. So I'm cranking up the harsh parts of my signals, about 3K, and these high frequencies as well. I've rolled out the low end here and here and here as well. So now the compressor is listening for the harsh parts, and when it's extra harsh, it's decreasing the volume. Again, you can use these bypass buttons to switch out the equalizer. or the compressor if you like. And those are the main settings of the internal routing of the SSL plugins. I'll go ahead and play you out this track so you can hear what's going on. Maybe bypass all the plugins and bring them back in, give you a better idea.